Ons volgende gas, is my baie lekker dat hy hier is, maar ook nie, wat ek gaan later tandarts toe vandag, and he used the word jaw clamp, injection,
jaw bit.
I want to welcome you, Graeme Watkins, but also hate you now, because I'm so scared. And also Graeme Watkins' project. Welcome again.
Yes, thank you for having me, guys. It's such a pleasure to be back. Thank you. Yeah.
And you were awake last night.
I was awake the whole night. Yeah, that's actually what brought on our conversation was the fact that my toddler's teething at the moment.
Yeah.
So he's pushing new ones out. So I think that's why we do it when we're young, so we don't remember, because it must be horrible.
Luckily, I don't think he's going to remember that. So, how's it going? You busy?
Super busy, super fun, super blessed. Yeah, new stuff's doing really well on radio and on social media. We really are leaving a wonderful footprint. So, yeah, can't complain. Mm.
And then we also talked about your new video.
Yeah.
And the song, and you know, what's the plan for the rest of the year?
So rest of the year, we'll sort of tour out here. Obviously, my other projects are doing well as well. And, you know, sort of corporate season sort of starts now. But we're definitely going to do the European thing next year. I think it's important. We've already started sort of sowing the seeds there. So, yeah, it's exciting times. 2018, I think, is going to be the year for us.
Yeah. And if you say Europe, specific countries?
Yeah, I think Germany is a huge territory. And I mean, they still have, they've got like a huge concert every like weekend, you know what I mean? So it's a nice thing. Obviously, it's going to be hard. You know, you've got to start all over again, the hard slogs, and you've got to tour and live in a bus and sleep in a hotel room with 7 other people. But that's cool. You know, it's living the dream.
Mm. Yeah. And then we're going to get to you opening for Midnight Oil, but you're in the band environment, and with guys, I don't know, coming and going, or, you know, the dynamics of the group, you know, how's that for you? And you're basically a solo artist, but with a band.
Yeah, well, not really. My band writes with me.
We're all like this one thing.
We are one entity.
Okay.
We don't swap out members. Mm. We've been together from the start. 2011, we released our first album together, which we all wrote together. The band is named after me, but that was obviously the Idols sort of brand, and, you know, keeping that kind of identity. But it's definitely a four-piece unit.
The reason I asked that is just to show how lazy they were not to get up for this interview. No, I'm joking.
That's what I said.
Sorry, guys, but this is, I'm going to do it for the band.
No.
Sometimes you're a fan of someone, or it happens, like I know Cat Stevens is coming to South Africa.
Yeah, man.
And if someone asks me, will you just do one song? I probably won't be able to do it because I'm a big fan. Midnight Oil. This weekend opening for Midnight Oil. When a call like that comes.
Yeah, you know what? Like I was saying to you off air, one of my earliest memories of, you know, when you still want to be an aspiring young musician and a rock star, air guitaring with my best mate on the couch to Beds Are Burning, and just loving everything about the way that song makes you feel. And those 80s bands were just prolific, you know, and they represent such an important time in the history of music. And especially for me, I'm a huge 80s boy. I love the 80s, you know. So to open for them, wow, what a pleasure, man.
Mm. And even the band, is there something special that you're planning?
Nothing really special. Mm. I think hopefully just to be able to live up to the brand and do what we do. I think if we do what we do well, then everything will go according to plan. And the nice thing is it's during the day as well. So, you know, people that don't often get to see us because we're playing in some dark, dingy nightclub somewhere. Come out and see us a family day. I think Midnight Oil go on at 2 p.m.
Okay.
So it's going to be a lekker.
And it's at
Mark's Park. I think it is. Yeah.
Yes,
and I think Freshly Grounded there, Prime Circle. It's going to be. I think it kicks off at 10:30 a.m. Yeah, it's going to be fun.
Are you watching Idols? You know it's on again.
I know it's on again, but if I hear the voting art music, I actually
just go like. Yeah. Okay, we've got a minute. I've got you. A questionnaire, Midnight Oil.
Yes.
Are you ready?
Okay.
What was their first name before they were Midnight Oil? Difficult one. I don't know.
I don't know.
Farm.
The Farm.
Just Farm.
Oh, Farm.
Howard.
I'm glad Midnight Oil took the reins.
Yeah. What year did they start?
I'm going to go with 1982.
72.
These guys, joking.
Starting 72. The Mr. Garrett, what did he become? As a musician, after they decided to take a break. You won't believe this.
He became a computer salesman.
Sure. He became the minister.
You are joking.
In Australia, of environment, heritage, and arts in 2007. Because he studied law. He was a law student, and it's just actually amazing. He joined the band because of an ad. They were looking for a band member, and that he saw an ad. But yeah, he was
all
a minister.
All the great bands start that way, man.
All with ads and politicians.
Yeah.
So I'll see you and Helen Ziller in 10 years'
definitely,
time.
Definitely, the
Graeme Watkins DA project.
DA project, yeah, that sounds great. I'm right in there.
The blue band.
Will I put Moosey on bass?
Yeah. Moosey on bass. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much
and
for having me.
And congratulations to be part of that.
Thank you very much. And I hope to see everybody there.
Yes, you're going to see me there. I've got a fantastic company team building weekend.
Enjoy your root canal.
Enjoy your root canal. This is the end. Ek gee weet wat, ek gaan net so my gaan vir ons luister as Henry praat films en ons luister Erasure, 80s Little Respect.
Yeah.